It is my immense pleasure to present this presentation for MSc students of our college, Kadirmayum College, Adrambattinam. And this topic is present in Physical Chemistry 1 syllabus for MSc students. This topic is very simple, but this topic is frequently asked in the university examination. This topic, principle of microscopic reversibility, this topic is present in Unit 3 of Physical Chemistry, one paper for PG students. This rise was a request to viewers. The principle of microscopic reversibility, this is for reversible reaction, which consists of two opposing processes. One is forward reaction, another one is backward reaction. According to this principle, in a system at equilibrium, any molecular process and the reverse of that process occur on the average at the same rate. That is a principle. Now consider the process A plus B, reversible arrow Y plus Z, and here A plus B are A and B are reactants and Y and Z are products, and the rate constant for the forward reaction is K1 and the rate constant for backward reaction is K minus 1. At equilibrium, the rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reaction. So K1 into concentration of A and concentration of B, that is equal to K minus 1 concentration of Y and concentration of Z. And the ratio K1 by K minus 1, that is equal to concentration of product divided by concentration of reactant. That ratio, that is a constant, that is equilibrium constant. For any mechanism involving any number of elementary and consecutive steps, the overall equilibrium constant is the product of the equilibrium constants for the individual steps and is the ratio of product of the rate constant for the reactions in the forward reaction and the product of rate constants for the reverse reactions. That is, now consider the reaction A to X and from X to Z. So it consists of two reversible reactions. One is A to X, another one is X to Z. And for A to X, the rate constant of forward reaction is K1, and to that of backward reaction K minus 1. And for X2 Z reversible reaction, the rate constant is K2 for forward reaction, and K minus 2 is the rate constant for backward reaction for this second reversible reaction. Now the equilibrium constant Kc, that is the product of equilibrium constant for first equilibrium reaction and the equilibrium constant of second reversible reaction, that is capital K1 and capital K2. Yeah, these are the equilibrium constant for first two reversible and that of second reversible reaction. That is, K1 is the equilibrium constant for reversible reaction A to X, and K2 is the equilibrium constant for the second reversible reaction, that is X to Z. And K1 is the rate constant for forward reaction for A to X, and K2, that is the rate constant of forward reaction from X to Z. And K minus 1, that is a rate constant of backward reaction for the reversible reaction A to X, and K minus 2 is the rate constant for the reversible reaction, that is a backward reaction for reversible reaction X to Z. So now the equilibrium constant Kc, that is the product of equilibrium constant of for first reaction and for second reaction, that is equal to K1, K2 divided by K minus 1, K minus 2. Now, according to this principle, the equilibrium constant is the ratio of rate constants of forward reaction to that of backward reactions. So, now we can prove Kc is equal to K1, K2 divided by K minus 1, K minus 2. For that, the net rate of the reaction minus dA by dt, that is equal to K1A minus K minus 1 X. That is, in the first reversible reaction, first A is decomposed. So, net rate of decomposition of A, that is net rate of the reaction, that is equal to K1A minus K minus 1 X, because the reaction is net rate of disappearance. So, K1A which is positive and minus K minus 1 X as negative. So, this is a net rate of the reaction, net rate of decomposition of A. Let it be 1, that is minus dA by dt, that is equal to k1A minus k minus 1 x. When the system at equilibrium, net rate of formation of intermediate x, that is dx by dt, that is equal to k1A plus k minus 2 z minus k minus 1 plus k2 into x, concentration of x. That is plus sign that gives the rate of formation of x and minus sign gives the rate of disappearance of x. So net rate of x, that is intermediate dx by dt, that is equal to k1A minus k1 minus 1 plus k2 x plus k minus 2 z. The plus sign is for rate of formation and the minus sign for rate of disappearance. So according to steady state principle, this is equal to 0, that is net rate of formation of the intermediate is equal to 0. So I am simplifying this equation, we get x is equal to k1a plus k minus 2 z divided by k minus 1 plus k2. That is by simply changing minus from left hand side to right hand side. And the equation for x is equal to k1a plus k minus 2 z divided by k minus 1 plus k2. Let this equation be 2. On substituting equation 2 in 1, that is net disappearance of A, that is net rate of the reaction, that is minus dA by dt, that is equal to k1 into concentration of A minus k minus 1 into concentration of x, the value is substituted from equation 2. So on taking LCM, LCM is minus k minus 1 plus k2, on taking LCM, the first term becomes two terms, that is k1a k minus 1 plus k1a k2, and the another term is minus k minus 1 k1a plus k minus 2 z, that is minus dA by dt, that is equal to k1a k minus 1 plus k1a k2 minus k minus 1 k1a and plus k minus 1 k minus 2 z. Now I am cancelling plus term of k1a k minus 1 with minus term of k minus 1 k1a. So the final equation becomes minus dA by dt is equal to k1 k2 a divided by the LCM k minus 1 plus k2 minus k, k minus 1 k minus 2 z divided by the LCM k minus 1 plus k2. So this equation has two terms, first term rate of forward reaction and second term rate of backward reaction, and that is first one is rate of the reaction from left to right, that is forward, and the second term is the rate of backward reaction, that is from right to left, that is backward reaction, and the rate constants for forward reaction is k1 k2 divided by k minus 1 plus k2, that is the rate constant of forward reaction, and the rate constant of backward reaction is k minus 1 k minus 2 divided by k minus 1 plus k2. So I already told the rate constant for backward reaction, that is from right to left, that is k minus 1 k minus 2 divided by k minus 1 plus k2. Now the ratio of the two rate constants, that is rate constant for forward reaction to that of backward reaction, that is by cancelling the LCM on numerator and the denominator. So the final equation k rate ratio is k1 k2 divided by k minus 1 k minus 2, that is equal to the equilibrium constant. So for a system not at equilibrium, the ratio of rate constants of forward reaction and backward reaction may be very different from the equilibrium constant, but the ratio is constant at equilibrium. These are about principle of microscopic reversibility. So according to this principle, the ratio of rate constants of forward reactions, if it contains number of steps, that is rate constant is k1, k2, k3, etc., and the rate constant backward reaction k minus 1, k minus 2, k minus 3, etc., the ratio is a constant, that is the principle of microscopic reversibility. With this, I want to conclude my presentation on the topic principle of microscopic reversibility. This topic is very simple, and the questions from this topic is frequently asked in the university examination. So I wish all the students all success. Thank you.